Listen, hey. I'm having a pin for the customers.
Hey, how are you?
Good.
You for the party?
No, I came to check on my kid. Every New Year's Eve, the art department challenges the business department to a little tourney.
Yes, the Bowman Cup. I've heard all about it. You'll be happy to know that your guys are cleaning up in there.
Go, team, go!
You can't stay alone?
No, I have a date.
Oh, wish I could stay the same.
How are you holding up?
Well, it took a while, but I think it finally sunk in.
That Trish and Chuck are back together, you know?
Did you have to say their names?
I'm sorry.
I saw them together the other day, holding hands like a couple of teenagers. But it's back to planning for me.
Which is?
Give me your rich, your handsome, your unattached, and the hell with love.
Hey, Bowman, your presence is requested on lane 6.
Hang in there, kiddo. Tomorrow's a new year.
Finally.
Yeah?
I've got this brunch tomorrow I have to go to, and, well, the thing is, I need a date. I thought maybe I could twist your arm.
Oh, I see. Well,
Sam?
Oh.
You talked by the jukebox, remember? The Lennon-McCartney debate? So I figured we'd do this brunch thing, and then maybe after that we could fight some more. What do you say?
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun and everything, but...
Yeah! Okay, sorry. One more, Mr. Maxwell, huh? Hey.
Boy, what a date.
Is Sandy wearing you out?
Oh, he is a little powerhouse. I mean, how did I get a son like that? Me?
Oh, gee, I don't know. Did he get you on the roller coaster?
Oh, he tried. Thank God he wasn't tall enough. Oh, I wish you didn't have to go to work tonight.
It's not going to be long. I've just got to drop these tapes off and do a short weird study. I'll be back.
What, you're not doing the live broadcast from Checkers?
Oh, no, not for me. That's way too public. Jimmy's going to handle that. Jimmy's going to be the DJ.
Oh. Yeah, I don't feel very public tonight either. Especially not at Checkers. Too many people know me. I'm not ready to face that.
I got an idea. Why don't we make this New Year's Eve like no other and go out and find a justice of the peace?
And do what? Take him on the roller coaster?
What? No.
Are you serious?
Of course I'm serious.
Yes!
Hold that thought. Hello?
Hi, Paul. It's Carly.
What's up?
I just caught Michael trying to climb out of his window.
What?
Yeah, he wants to spend tonight with you. Could you help me out?
Can I call you back?
Sure.
It was Carly.
Let me guess. We can't get married tonight because Carly needs a babysitter.
He's my son.
No, that's right. That's right. And what am I to you? Exactly. What am I, your fiancé, or I'm your girlfriend? What am I at this point? Because I don't know, Paul. I don't even know what... I don't even know what I want anymore.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means that my sister and your son aren't going to go away. I don't know what that means for us.
Well, you know, you're not the only person whose life's been interrupted, Ava. I've got a son. I've got a son, and he's 10 years old. He's been spending the last 10 years of his life running around, I don't know where, on his own. Got a lot of catching up to do.
I know.
I don't know what this means for us. But Michael's gonna be a big part of my life.
Big part of our life. honey. Call him.
You sure?
Tell him to come over. Yeah. And we can't find the justice of the peace tonight anyway. It's New Year's Eve. What were you thinking? No, oh.
Just some love. Thank you. Yeah, Carly?
Yeah.
Listen, I've got to go by the radio station. Why don't you bring Michael by there?
Oh, Paul, I didn't know you had to work.
No, yeah, it's not a big deal. I'm not going to be there very long.
So he can come home and spend the night with me.
Oh, great. Well, thank you.
Is that all right?
Yeah, it's just that I was looking forward to spending my first New Year's with him. You know, I bought these party favors and noisemakers, but next year.
Right? He's just more comfortable with me right now.
That's a consoling thought.
Well, then this way, you've got the night off.
Yeah. Although I do have something that I can attend to.
You'll be fine with me.
I'll take good care of him.
Thanks.
Happy New Year.
Yeah. Better hurry.
Yeah, I'll be right back.
Okay.
Okay. Ava? Honey, thank you for being so understanding.
I'm a saint.
Well, sometimes. Like he really needs me tonight. Bye.
He's not the only one.
All right, you got your picture. Now, what do you say we call it a night?
Yeah, sure, sure. Mr. Maxwell, has your father decided to throw his hat in the ring?
I'm afraid you're going to have to ask him that yourself.
What hat in the ring?
My father's considering running for president.
Of the United States?
Yeah, I think that's the one.
Sir, Senator Maxwell claims neutrality on the issue of abortion. What's his personal view?
Again, I'm afraid you're going to have to ask him that yourself.
Come on. Off the record.
I really don't know. Now, if you don't mind...
Can you tell me if you have any plans for New Year's Eve?
Nothing worth printing, I'm afraid. You want high society? Go check out my sister. She won't disappoint you.
Thanks.
I'm sorry about that.
No. No, I don't mind.
Oh, yeah, you say that now, but wait till you open up the paper and there we are. The press will probably have us married off by morning.
Really think they'll print our picture?
Well, when your dad's a senator and they're hard up for news, it could happen. Listen, I'm really sorry about all this. I'll get out of your hair.
Sam! Wait a second. I've got a few things to do here around the bar. Seems like that's all I ever do, but after that, we're having a little party.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Yeah, it should be fun. Why don't you stick around? I need to talk to you.
Yeah, we'll make it quick. I'm on my way out.
Maybe this isn't the best time.
It's as good a time as any. Besides, I don't think we have that much to talk about, do we?
As a matter of fact, I have quite a lot to say to you.
Well, you got about 3 minutes. It's New Year's. Time to celebrate, party.
Okay, could you give me a break on that hurrying stuff for like 2 minutes? When you stormed out of the house, I really wanted to go chasing after you. But I didn't allow myself to. You call that a response?
Oh, are you done?
Boy, you're really making this difficult for me.
No, Carly, you got that backwards. I'm making it easy for you. You want it out, you're out, you're free. Now go live your life.
I never said I wanted out.
Not in so many words.
But listen to my words. I want to be with you.
I've heard that one before, Carly.
I never meant for things to turn out like this. I never meant to fall in... for my feelings for you to be this way, and that's why I didn't follow you when you left. My life is a
mess. Is a mess, etc. Carly, I've heard that 200 times.
But it is my life. I just got Michael back, and I don't know which way is up. It's not a good time to be crazy for you.
Carly, look, I've had it with your games, all right? And would you leave?
I'm not leaving until you listen to
me. There's nothing else to talk about, Carly.
Yeah, you're right. I can't make sense of any of the words I try to say.
What are you doing?
I'm telling you something.
I'm not getting pulled in.
I love you.
What?
I just said that I love you.
Okay, now you gotta promise me you won't make any noise when I'm on the air.
I know, I'm not brain dead.
Oh, say, you wanna do those promo cards for...
Huh?
All right, that's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, no, it's okay.
No, like hell it is. This is the last time I'm gonna see you.
Andy, I'd like you to meet my son. My son, Michael.
You what?
I got other parents.
Yeah, I'll explain the whole long story to you some other time.
Okay.
And I gave the promo charge to Lisa. She's got it.
Great. Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you sure you're not going to go with us to Checkers to do the show? Or...
Yeah, I'm positive.
It's going to be a lot of fun, and it's going to be a big party.
Yeah, and I told you before that I don't think my public wants to see tough guy grounded.
You mean you're not going because of your chair?
Yeah.
It's no big deal.
Come on, Paul. Why don't you listen to the kid? Come on.
Yeah, why don't you go and have a good time?
All right, I'll try.
So what's this about you trying to climb out the window?
I wanted to go out.
Go out where?
Around.
Around? Michael, you want to be a little more specific?
I wanted to go check out the bar, see if I could find Ruth and Nick.
Ruth and Nick? You really miss them? Well, you mind hanging out and spend the night with me?
No, I don't mind.
Well, good. What do you say we do some weird city?
All right!
Well, you won't see many people out in Weird City tonight, because that's a tradition here on New Year's Eve. Everybody stays home, goes to bed early. That way, you can start the New Year's off with your eyes wide open. And I know that's what Tough Guy's gonna do. Yeah, he's had enough adventure to last himself a lifetime after following the mystery lady around.
As you remember, she was leading him to that secret he had to know about. Tough Guy wanted Beauty with him when he found out about the secret. And suddenly there she was, looking more beautiful than ever. So he took her by the hand and they laughed and danced their way out of town. Tough Guy loved Beauty more than anything. They planned to be married. But the secret was strong. The secret was so strong that it pulled him away, right into the storm. He followed Dark Eyes, hoping that Beauty would wait for him. Suddenly the storm was over, and there was a secret. It was a little boy, named MC, which obviously stood for magic creature. But he felt sad and alone with these new people in the strange place. But he was convinced to go with Tough Guy and Dark Eyes. And then his prayers were answered. Because Beauty was waiting for him, even though she felt lost and sad too. And all he could say to her was,
"I'm the luckiest man in the world." So, it's a good night. Happy New Year to all you people out there in Radio Land. Especially you, Beauty.
Hey, how's my favorite prof?
Oh, he's pulling for an A this semester. I'd ask you how you were doing, but that big smile kind of gives it away.
So you heading out?
Yeah.
I just came by to wish you a happy new year.
Uh-oh, my song. We've got to dance. Happy new year.
You know, Giff, I never would have thought that half pint could pull this place up out of the ashes. But I have to admit, she's doing a bang-up job.
She is a survivor, isn't she?
I can't argue with that.
Be interesting to see her next move.
This is for real.
Yes.
You're not going to run out in 10 minutes. You're not going to fight with me all night.
No, I'm staying. You're and staying. I'm not going anywhere. But you were leaving?
When I get dumped, you don't expect me to sit around and eat bonbons, do you? You guys going without me?
Oh, come on now. Come on now.
Look, I'm sorry. Something came up. Happy New Year. Where were we? I have wanted you for so long.
This one is for you.
Hey!
There you go. Toast, honey? Grape juice. It's very expensive, sparkling grape juice.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you. What a weird city story, honey. I loved it. Oh, have some cake. I baked
right.
It.
Yes,
I'll get a plate. I liked your story, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Thank you.
Anytime.
Anytime.
I'll get it. Hang on. Oh, my goodness. Hello?
Ava. Hey, it's Frankie. Listen, we got 2 million people here, and Lizzie just went home with the flu. Could you save my life and come in for, like, 2 hours? Ava? Sure, Frankie. I'll be right over. Oh, that's great. Thanks. I owe you one. Frankie. Lizzie is sick with the flu. I have to go to work.
Are you gonna go in? Sure you can handle it?
Yeah. I can handle it. Hey, you're not the only tough guy around here. You. Party with you later. Hey, Michael, why don't you cut the cake?
Happy New Year.
Paul? How come you're so scared?
Scared?
Of people seeing you in your chair.